Now to our ABC News exclusive powerful new interview with the parents of murdered college track star Lauren McCluskey. Her family is fighting for justice, saying her death could have been prevented. They sat down with Amy to talk about it. Good morning, Amy.
Yeah, good morning, guys. The parents of Lauren McCluskey describe her as bright and sensitive, and Lauren's life was tragically cut short after breaking up with a man who had a very disturbing past. It was a threat she and her parents tried warning authorities about numerous times before it was too late, and now her parents are opening up in an exclusive interview.
Was Lauren's death preventable?
Yes.
Absolutely.
This morning, the grieving parents of Lauren McCluskey are opening up for the first time since their daughter was killed on the University of Utah campus by a man she dated for just 1 month.
She was so excited about having a career, about, you know, having a family in the future, and we won't get to see any of that or experience any of that.
In October, the 21-year-old track star broke up with this man, Melvin Rowland, after discovering he was a registered sex offender on parole who lied about his age and identity. After the breakup, the 37-year-old began harassing her through email and text. McCluskey, feeling threatened, first contacted University of Utah campus police on October 12th.
University Police and Security, how can I help you?
Hi, this is Lauren. I called a few days ago about a situation, and I wanted to kind of give an update.
The college senior calling authorities on campus and at the Salt Lake City Police Department over the course of 10 days.
I'm worried because I've been working with the campus police at the U.
Uh-huh.
And last Saturday I reported and I haven't gotten an update.
One thing she did tell me is that she says it feels like I'm bothering them because she was calling so much. And then I remember telling her it's their job to listen to you, you know, if you're complaining.
But they weren't listening.
No, they weren't. They weren't taking her seriously.
Then, on the evening of October 22nd, tragedy struck.
Can you tell me? Can you walk me through what happened?
I was on the phone with her as she was coming home from class. And then all of a sudden she yells, no, no, no. And then the line was still open. And then Matt called 911.
She was abducted while we were talking to her on the telephone. So we heard her being assaulted.
At that moment, police say Rowland grabbed McCluskey, pulled her into a car, and shot her. Rowland later took his own life.
So this is Lauren's room.
At their home in Washington State, Lauren's track medals still hang on the wall. The McCluskeys now say the University of Utah failed their daughter.
They should have investigated. They would have very quickly found his parole status and one call, and we wouldn't be sitting here today.
Shortly after her death, the University of Utah's president releasing an independent review of the case and announcing actions to improve campus safety.
The report does not offer any reason to believe that this tragedy could have been prevented.
The university president said that there was nothing that could have been done to prevent Lauren's death. I just had a sick stomach for days after that.
In a statement to ABC News, the university says they grieve Lauren's loss and that their report, quote, identified areas of deficiency in the university's systems and processes and made 30 recommendations for ways to improve them. The university is acting immediately to correct the deficiencies.
If that's true, if there was no way, then why are all of these reforms being implemented, these changes? It would be pointless.
When asked about this directly, the university again acknowledged serious mistakes were found and is now working to correct them. This as the McCluskeys start a new foundation in Lauren's honor, hoping to improve campus safety and celebrate their daughter's life.
Are you angry?
Mostly sad.
You know, the sadness is so complete. I don't have room for anger.
But we do want change.
The University of Utah says they are increasing training for officers and hiring a victim advocate who will work closely together with detectives. You can read about their full implementations on our website. In addition to promoting campus safety, the McCluskey's new foundation also supports charitable work in areas that were very important to Lauren, athletics and animal welfare. And you can learn more at laurenmccluskey.org. But her mother told me at one point Lauren called a detective 22 times. She did everything right. She called for help. She just didn't get what she needed.
Mm. It's amazing they're finding the strength in their sadness to try to get these changes now.
It is. That's their only way forward. Their son, Lauren's brother, and making sure that campuses are safe and Lauren's passions are funded.
Just leaves you speechless.
It sure does. Yeah. Thank you, Amy. And all of you can see much more of Amy's interview with the McCluskeys tonight on Nightline. Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.